Hey, what's going on, guys? It's your boy, Pro Gamer here, and we are back with yet another video, this time with the game Life is Strange Wavelengths, which is the DLC to the game Life is Strange True Colors. Now, as you guys probably know, we did finish up Life is Strange True Colors recently. What a fun series that was. Yet again, bringing that Life is Strange goodness back to the channel. But they do also have a 4-hour DLC where we get to play as Steph Gingrich. And as you guys know, I'm a big Life is Strange fan. So you guys think I'm not going to take the opportunity to play an extra 4 hours of Life is Strange content? So I'm ready to go. I've got my good old Life is Strange flanny on. So without further ado, let's get back into some more Life is Strange content with Steph's story. Have you played Life is Strange Season 1? Yes, we have. Now, I need to actually go back and check this because when I played Life is Strange 2, I do remember I picked the wrong decision. So, actually, I'm just going to do a quick check to make sure I get this decision right because, as you guys know, we have played Life is Strange 1 on the channel. It was about 5 or 6 years ago at this point, but we have played it. So give me a quick sec. I'm gonna make sure we get the right decision and I'll be back. After that little trip down memory lane, and our decision actually was to save Arcadia Bay. So yes, we did decide to save Arcadia Bay. I think in Life is Strange 2, we had an option as well because when I first played my very first series of Life is Strange on the channel, I actually played that on PC, whereas now I've played all the other games on PlayStation. So, and yeah, as you guys can tell, it's been a while since I've played those games. Even before the storm, sorry. Even Life is Strange 2, I think, is going back at least 2 years at this point. Which is crazy to think about. Life is Strange Wavelengths is a story-based game that features player choice actions and decisions will have consequences for Steph and those around her. Choose wisely. Here we go with some Life is Strange Wavelengths. Come on, Steph, where you at? Okay. We got the DJ booth going. No music, I really hope. Okay. I have not changed the settings, so we should still have music if there's meant to be. Okay, I don't think there's meant to be music. I was gonna say, that'd be real awkward if that setting had changed. Welcome to Haven Springs.
Steph, Gingrich? Is that how you say it?
Oh, indeed it is.
Yeah, that's right. What kinds of radio have you done before? God, let's see. What haven't I done? College radio, small town station, did a couple podcasts.
Did a couple YouTube videos with your boy Pro Gamer over here. Not really radio, but isn't that what I mean?
Oh, okay. So you know your way around an audio booth.
Okay, watch out for the microphone. We do not need to be breaking anything on our first day in the studio.
Your friend did tell me you were overqualified for this job. I just assumed he was, you know, being Gabe, right? Well, look, if you can handle it without much supervision, the job's yours.
Awesome.
Nice.
Now, part of your responsibilities would be managing the record store. Given all your retail experience on your resume, I'm sure that won't be a problem.
We gotcha.
Right. Yeah, no problem at all.
Exactly.
Great. So your friend said you quit your band to be here. Can I ask why? Sorry. Maybe that's too personal.
No, it's fine. No big reason. I'm just trying to...
See, because that was the band of Izzy, wasn't it?
Okay. There was a breakup involved.
Ah.
So I wanted a change of scenery. A new job in a gorgeous place.
Yeah, they ended up becoming a murder town.
I hope we live up to expectations. Haven Springs is no Seattle.
I think I'll love it.
I'm sure you will. And I'ma love it too! See, and yet again, because of that choice as well at the start of the episode, I had heard there was meant to be some kind of impact from your final decision in Life is Strange 1.
The manager left me a task list for my first day. So that's probably around here somewhere. Are you the Haven High mascot?
No, I just figured, you know, we got a task list, but let's just play with the bobblehead. But okay, fine.
Great.
What do we got?
Here's the list.
Steph, welcome to your first shift. Sorry I can't be there. Here are the basics. Introduce yourself. Use the computer to play the auto DJ. Read all ads on air. Ad copy is on the desk. It's very unlikely, but some folks might call in. This probably goes without saying, but if someone calls, answer. Good luck, Beatrice. Okay, well, thank you very much, Beatrice.
Introduce myself on air? Huh.
Okay.
Let's give this a shot.
Yeah, I would say use the microphone, but yes, as someone who's made many, many errors with recording over the years and had many recording mistakes, let's make sure it's turned on first. Trust me on that one. Really, really useful tip.
What's up, kind Haven listeners? Steph here.
Oh yeah, we are the music maestro.
KRCT's new maestro of music, sultan of songs, tyrant of tunes. You get the picture. We've got some great music coming up for you, so keep it here. You're listening to KRCT.
Oh,
I promised great music, so next up, check out the playlist.
I want to try and get an orange color, but you know what, pink? Close enough to red and stuff, I guess. Want to keep those pro gamer vibes going in our recording booth.
This is Haven's number one indie rock playlist. Pretty sparse.
Well, I'm guessing that's why we're hired here for the job. Let's be honest here. Okay, auto DJ, blah, blah, upgrade to pro, sure.
It'll do.
We'll get the job done. Yet again, as someone who does their own recordings with what I like to call a glorified office PC, you can really stretch technology if you need to.
It's my turn now.
Paint me silver, fall asleep, home for oaks, talking distance. I don't know why, but I quite like the look of this one, so we'll get on with it. Plus, it always looks like a light tower, kind of like in Life is Strange 1. And you know I like to throw back to other Life is Strange series.
Shaking things up already, Gingrich. Maybe I can play a few more songs today.
We can fit the others in.
Now I'm supposed to read some ad copy.
All right, what do we got?
Be around here too.
The Black Lantern. Avalanche, you know what? I'm gonna give the sponsorship to Avalanche Ice Cream. Can we? Yes. Cool. Wait, please don't call us that. Our last name is Anderson. Okay, cool. I'm just going for Avalanche Ice Cream.
Here's a new local business to get excited about. Avalanche Ice Cream in downtown Haven Springs. The variety of flavors they've got is gonna blow your freaking mind.
They better have some good old choc chip there for us. They got the classics, but they also experiment too.
You think I'm kidding? These guys have, and I hope you're sitting down.
What?
Crab Rangoon flavored ice cream. Just saying. So come on down to Avalanche Ice Cream and get yourself a scoop from our good pals.
Can someone tell me what Crab Rangoon ice cream is? And did they want, I don't know, was it Avalanche?
The, ice cream couple. Ooh, I need a break. I'll just step away from the desk for a sec.
Please don't call us that. Our last name is Anderson. Oh. My bad. I got that one wrong. But
a message from one of KRCT's sponsors, the Black Lantern. Here in Haven,
not mean to do that.
Black Lantern is known for
historical decor.
The historical decor. Where else can you feast under a used pickaxe and a literal bullet hole? That's right, nowhere.
Yeah.
And then there's the food. Try the lanterns.
We'll go with the burgers.
Top notch.
Everyone loves a good old burger.
Best burgers for 20 miles in any direction, bar none. Stop by the Black Lantern today and tell them Steph sent you.
What about the best bartender? Not in Jed, but in my guy Gabe. Okay, can we, let's quickly browse. What do we got? Oh, so these are just all the same. Okay, but so yeah, sorry, last thing I was gonna say. Yeah, what is Crab Rangoon? Oh, wait. It says no. Oh, they don't have Crab Rangoon, do they? Oh boy! My bad on that one. Let's just leave for a little bit, shall we?
I've been meaning to fill out my dating app profile.
Yeah. Let's do that. We so far, let's be honest, haven't been making the bestest of decisions so far. Not been a great start to our job.
This is your life.
Yes, but also, Steph, I like to see we're matching. I got the black shirt, you got the white shirt, that's fine. I don't got the beanie on today, but I like to see you also joining in with the red Life is Strange flannies. You know what series this is. Appreciate you joining in with the community. Let's go something jerky. Have a bit of fun with it. So Steph, she, her, 24, Haven Springs, Colorado. Tagline, massive dork 6 next. X. About me, or what do your potential matches need to know about you? Musician, gamer, cat lover, impulsive traveler, gay disaster, and aspiring DJ. I do want to go with option A because game is in there and I am a gamer, but I do got to admit, option 2 does sound pretty cool.
Next, gotta out myself as a media snob. It's only fair. What kind of stuff do I want to name drop?
Oh, games for sure.
And top it off with a dash of what I'm looking for.
Something serious, a community of fun. Let's find the serious partner, why not? Here we go, so about me. Disaster queer, moved here on a whim to DJ at a radio station. I'll beat you at Dino Racer, looking for a genuine connection, not here for one night stands. Very nice indeed. And you'll find that, just wait a little longer. Alex will be here soon, you can get together, you can be happy when your boy PG Cupid over here sets you up, and you'll be happily ever after. But this is like a year in the past, so, you know, before Alex even comes, so eventually, we'll get there. Okay, what do we got? Mikey! If you guys don't remember, Mikey was the guy that played, was it D&D with Steph in Before the Storm, so, oh boy. Now, I am reading all these messages. You know, I am probably going to skip through a lot of messages because there's probably going to be a lot of reading. However, I am reading Mikey's. I really hope this is the right number. If the person reading this is Steph, hey, it's Mikey. Been a minute. Oh my goodness, hey. Damn, dude, it's been ages. How'd you find me? I had a diff number last time we talked. Lol, you're in the alumni directory. Seriously? I know. I thought it was weird too. Man, you donate $5 one time. Anyway, damn dude, how are you? Yeah, I'm good. You know how it is. Yeah. Actually, no, I have no idea how it is. No, I guess you don't. I'm still kicking around, going into grad school, so that's dope. How about you? One, that is dope. Congrats on grad school. Yeah, indeed. Two, lol, no idea. I split. Oh, for real? Where are you now? Haven Springs, Colorado. What is that like, a suburb of Denver? See, that would have been a smart place to move to. No, it's way out in BFE. Don't know what that means, but sure. Long story. Well, if you ever want to tell it, I'm all ears. Oh, nice indeed, my guy. Okay, so we got Jerry. What's going on with Jerry, my guy? Hey, we're doing a show at Snot House on the 25th. Tigans, Riz, Attack of Lanterns, and y'all, if you want in. B-Y-O-Y-O-B. You haven't read. I kind of moved out of Seattle. Really? When? Like, a week ago? Damn, is easy with you? Nope. Sorry, dude. I don't think DSM is a thing anymore. Damn, F's in the chat. Okay, we got Izzy, so it was his ex-partner. Hey, home safe? I think it'd be best if I blocked your number. It's not personal. I just feel like the temptation to text you would be too much. And I want to let you go, and I want to let you get on with whatever it is you're doing out there. So, bye. This user has blocked incoming SMS messages from your number. Damn. That's rough. I'm sorry, Steph. I'm sorry to hear. But things will get better. I know they will. I have seen the future. I kind of find it ironic as well how I said, you know what? I'm probably not going to read all these text messages, yet here I am reading absolutely every single word of all these text messages. But I'm sorry, I lost Gabe in episode... Spoiler alert, but if you guys are watching this series, I don't know why you're watching this before True Colors, but anyway, spoiler alert, Gabe died in episode 1, so I need to have as much conversation with my guy as I can. Yo, hey, it's Steph from Drugstore Makeup. What up, bud? So, okay, talk to Izzy and we're in for the gig. It'll be good to have a stop between SLC and Denver. Sick. Can't wait for you guys to play up here. You're gonna love it. Hell yeah. Think you could put me up for a few days? Don't you have more tour dates? Did something happen? No, not really. I was just thinking maybe I'd stick around Haven for a little longer than we originally planned. But not both of you? Look, man, can I crash with you or not? Yeah, of course. If you need to talk, hit me up. So I think I can get you a job in town if you're interested. So you can stop couch surfing and get your own place. Dude, maybe we ought to talk about that. Crack open some beers, I'll be there in 10. You know, if it were me, I don't think I'd bet my future on the outcome of a game I sucked that much at. Bro, I'm trying to sleep. Whatever, you'll sleep when you're dead. Ugh. Anyway, about that record store job though. Fine, I'll go in for the interview. Thanks, Gabe. You're the coolest friend a girl could have. Thanks, Gabe. Now let me sleep. Break a leg, kid. Thanks, man. Seriously, don't even mention it. And the last one. Because yet again, at this point, I'm going to read through all these texts, okay? I said I wasn't, but I'm going to. We're too far committed at this point. And I want to get as much Life is Strange goodness as I can. We've only got this series to go, so I got to wait for another Life is Strange game. System notification. You've been added to this group. SMS conversation by user Gabe Chen. If you believe this was a mistake, please block this number and contact your service provider. Gabe, submitted for the approval of Haven Springs Cool Kids Club, I'm newest member, Steph Gingrich. Ryan, welcome aboard. Charlotte, it's about time this group chat became less of a boys club. Yo, thanks for having me. Gabe, so movie night? Ryan, I'm always down for movie night. Gabe, dude, you're always down for nature documentary night. Soon as I want to put on Jurassic Park, you dip. Ryan, they don't have feathers. Where are the feathers, Gabe? Charlotte, oh god. Not this again. I'm down for movie night. What are we doing this? Charlotte, my place, Friday. I believe it's only fair that we let our newest member pick the movie. Gabe, what? I didn't agree to that. Too bad, my dude. The deed is done. I'm gonna get real weird with it. Ryan, okay. But look how weird. Real. Weird. Alright, so that's our text messages. Dating profile. Use L2 and R2 to dislike or like profiles. Okay, so L2 to dislike, R2 to like. So we've got Grace, 41, Gunnison, Colorado, mother of two, exploring a different side of myself. Fair enough, I wish you the best, but I think you're a little bit too old for what we're looking for. So I'm sorry. Bubbles. Your town, Colorado. This user hasn't entered a tagline yet. How mysterious. Interesting. Let's see what's going on. Like. Alright, match made. The feeling is mutual. Let's keep swiping for now. Caitlin, Haven Springs, Colorado. You miss every shot you don't take. Fair play. And you are also in Haven Springs.
Guess I should probably break the ice.
To be fair, I did actually mean to keep swiping, but... We're starting a message now. Play cool. Hey, how's your day going? Ah, boy. Okay, you're going to think I'm the world's biggest... this didn't end well, did it? I won't! Did you mistakenly swipe on us? Nah, probably not. I've met some pretty huge and nasty people. So I swiped right on accident. Alright, let's try and laugh it off. LOL. That's hilarious. Please tell me how that happened. I don't know. I keep checking my settings. It's supposed to show me dudes. Maybe I changed it without meaning to. So why'd you swipe? So wait. We've established how I showed up in your feed, but why'd you swipe right on me? You're gonna think this is dumb. Try me. I have a thing about names. Like, I don't even look at people's pics most of the time. I swipe based on whether or not I can imagine introducing a dude to my friends. So I was like, yeah. Hey, y'all. This is my boyfriend, Steph. And it sounded good. And I didn't even check. And, sorry for the confusion. It's kind of dumb, but it's kind of funny. Again, let's laugh it off. You're right. That's pretty dumb. Told you. Anyway, you seem really cool. Sorry for the weirdness. Not a problem. Take care. Alright. What's going on, Bubbles? Let's, sure.
How do you introduce yourself to someone named Bubbles?
I don't know, but we're making the first move here somehow. Let's just not say just hi. Try and see what we got. So is Bubbles your given name? Or do you have like an extremely cool story involving a foam party and or champagne? Hello, handsome. You're a bot, aren't you? How are you enjoying this weather? Okay, yeah, you are very much a bot. Can't believe I wasted my high quality foam party and champagne joke on a bot. Yeah. That's my fave kind of weather. I meant to click out, okay, I wanted to exit, but sure. We'll keep going. Alright, time to give you the Voigt Kempf test. You can smoke if you want, it won't affect the test. It's your birthday. Someone gives you a calfskin wallet. Don't you hate this app? Username not found. You should give me your number so we can text. You won't regret it. You're not even a good bot. My goodness, you're not even a good bot. Hello, scammer mission control. This one is broken. Message reply unknown. Hello, handsome. Yeah, no, we're leaving that. Leave the bot.
Probably work for me to do in the store as well.
When we meant to finish the ad read? I think. Well, we're not doing that anymore. Let's style up the store, shall we?
I think there was a note for me on the front counter.
How good it feels to be back. We got our good old studio, the good old artwork. The scene where, if you guys remember in the game, they actually referenced or had like a couple of Easter eggs to Life is Strange, or previous Life is Strange. There was one scene where the camera angle was looking at this, like Max's photo with her looking at a wall with all the photography images on the wall, as well as there's actually a Firewalk album, which is the band from Before the Storm, on the wall as well. Yes, since I finished my Let's Play, I have been checking out other people's Let's Plays and seeing their reactions and stuff, and I gotta admit, has really made me started to like really enjoy Life is Strange True Colors and have it grow on me so much more. Especially with the music too. Also, you can see we obviously haven't pulled out our drum kit yet.
Ooh. I had this melody in my head all night. Finally got out of bed and recorded it. I wonder how it sounds now. I could give it a listen.
I am
see if
down.
I still like it.
What do we got?
This is actually pretty sick.
Maybe we can turn it into a song.
Upgrading from humming to actual music is a good next step.
Well, okay. Let's see.
So what instrument should I play this thing on?
Oh. I'm going guitar. Never played... Oh.
I bet it'll sound cool as a guitar riff.
Never learned how to properly play one, but I did always think they're pretty cool. Yeah, being able to play the guitar. A very cool instrument indeed, but yeah. Alright, anything else of importance back here? Or someone?
Mostly, I'm totally at peace with my decision to quit the band and stay here.
The Seattle Scene. The Rainy City's number one free weekly. Local punk favorite drugstore makeup returns by Bernard Nelson. That's the hard thing about being a two-piece, explained frontwoman Izzy in... Explained frontwoman Izzy Insurrection. If you lose one person, that's half the band. Denizens of Seattle's punk venues may wonder what happened to the aggressive sets and black lipstick of drugstore makeup after months of silence. Following an unexpected lineup change, Izzy needs to pull together fresh talent. Our new drummer is a punk rock grenade. It's the kick-ass energy we need right now. From Steph, goblinchild at gingrich.net to George Gingrich, George at grinchdigital.co. Here we go, so stuff on her dad. Dad! I don't know what could be more grounded than undead nuns. They're literally buried underground. Did you write Shadows and Whiskey yet? It's got all that crime noir you love without the misogyny. Love me. P.S. Did you try making the trailer more like a trailer? P.P.S. No dead elk yet. But as always, tomorrow. From George Gingrich to Steph. Subject hello. Okay, cool. Cool. Well, it seems like she's emailing back and forth. Keep it in contact.
Your favorite musical, I take it.
You'd be doing the store a favor. Okay, and not a fan of the Backstreet Bingo. Also, we got that, those beats going on in the background. Kind of like a country music song a little bit.
Feel like I'd get along with
it. It's alright, but... Anyway. Dear Miss Gingrich, welcome to my store. Lord knows we need a fresh face. My name is Kasia Sobieski. Sobieski? Yet again, I've probably butchered that name. I'm sorry. And I'm an old bat in a nursing home in Colorado Springs. The Record Traders is very near to my heart. So anything you can do to improve the place, and I do mean anything, is greatly appreciated. Kind regards, Kasia. Some ideas? Better decor. Better music. Fixed vent cover in the back. Been falling off for years.
So, if I read that right, Kasia's basically giving me carte blanche. I can work with that.
We got the store to-
those posters? Maybe there's something to spruce up the walls. As for music, I can at least start it by updating the new releases.
Oh, we're gonna make this store!
Yep, there's the vent. Might as well take a look.
Yeah, we're gonna make this store ours. Give it that old Steph Gingrich, you know, masterpiece of that extra just bonus on top. That nice Steph Gingrich twist to it all, you know? Okay, what do we got? Posters!
One of these might work.
But which one? Woman of Power, oops! Wait. Woman of Power, oops! Sure.
That sounds promising.
Why not? Women of Power! Support the local community women!
Cool.
I'm sure they are very strong,
Shit.
Very kind.
That's coming from inside the booth.
Indeed, alright.
First call.
Alright,
better go answer it.
Let's go answer this phone! When that appears, there is a call waiting in the DJ. Okay, can we enter, please? Thank you. Okay, we got a call in the DJ booth. We should probably also do that last ad break as well. So we'll get on to that. Okay, hello, hello, who's on the line?
Hello? You're on KRCT Radio and you're talking to Steph.
Yo, this the record store?
This is the DJ booth, not the record store.
Close, but no. As I said, this is KRCT Radio, Haven's only radio station.
Indeed it is.
You're looking for Rocky Mountain Record Traders. Haven's only record store.
So, I should call them?
Yes.
Well, no, because you'd need me. And I'm in here talking to you. Follow?
No.
Just call the record store.
My order, and you can just, like, give it to whoever.
Yeah, why not?
Alright, what do we got?
Sweet. Alright, I got Goodbye Means Forever by Kim Snyder, Going Our Separate Ways by The Seagulls, Don't Let the Door Hit You by Robbie Rooster.
Ah, boy.
Oh, boy.
What?
No, nothing. Just, who are these for?
My girlfriend. I saw them in her wish list online and decided to surprise her. Buy local, you know?
Yeah,
nice.
Yeah, cool. Yeesh. I don't think this kid realizes that his girlfriend is loading up on breakup music.
Oh.
Okay. Look.
Yeah, maybe she's telling you something.
I wonder if your girlfriend might be sending out some signals you're not picking up on.
Yeah, you lost me there.
All right, dude, listen. I'm pretty sure your girlfriend's breaking up with you.
Yeah.
How the hell would you know that?
Gee, I don't know. Guess I'm psychic.
No, whatever, that's
lady.
Alex.
Screw this.
Thanks for calling KRCT.
My bad! Let's do our final ad read. Get it done out of the way.
let's hear from one of our sponsors.
Indeed we shall.
PutToWorkColorado.com has been putting Coloradans to work since 2002, using
very
their...
Good, very good indeed. Using... Oh, I should have read this. Job portal?
Super slick job portal. Seriously, I'm not even gonna tell you how it works. It's that easy to use. But Steph, you say, I'm a unique artisan with a highly specialized skill set. No way they'll have a job for me. To which I say, not with that attitude. And just for my listeners, get a free trial membership with promo code KRCT.
Okay, let me just look at this for a second.
Supporting KRCT.
Okay, so if we look at our sponsors.
It is now too late.
So we have the Black Lantern, talk up the Black Lantern, include the following, the atmosphere, the good food. Okay, so we did that one right. Colorado.com works the intuitive work job portal. Okay, we did that one right. Avalanche Ice Cream, we got that one wrong. So, look, we're 2 for 3. Could be worse. I was going to say, don't tell me, because remember with the Black Lantern one, we had to pick between a burger and jalapeno poppers or something? I was like, don't tell me. We've got all these ads wrong. But hey, without even looking at it, we got some right, so. Not bad. Okay, so we got Greta, 27, Parlin, Colorado. Keep Colorado goth. Fair enough, but I think we're gonna say no, unfortunately. Kylie, 25, Haven Springs, Colorado. Are you the one we're looking for? Why not? We'll like you. Winnie, 28, Gunnison, Colorado. Wanna get high and watch anime? Okay, you know, why not?
You're kidding.
Well, there is no one else in our area. Eh, well. Mikey, what's going on, my guy? Where we at? Where's the current message? Hey! Steph! Hey! Did you get that package I sent you? Hey! Not yet, but I brought it with me to work. First day. Wish me luck. It's on the counter. Wait, was that it? Was there more I gotta read? No, that's it. Okay. Very nice indeed. On the counter. What did you send? What'd you send, Mikey? What do we got?
No contact for 2 years. Then this mysterious package? Well played, Mikey.
From Mikey North. And we have another pro gamer unboxing video montage here featuring Steph Gingrich. So what do we got? Steph, do the honors. What do we have?
All my old GM stuff. Holy shit.
We got some D&D equipment, baby. My guy, Mikey, coming up in clutch.
Mikey really went for the nostalgia. Guess I should look through everything.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Oh my god, this takes me back.
Oh, please, please say this game can pick up our Life is Strange Before the Storm playthrough and it still has Calamastia as a character in here. Do not read. Warning, proceeding further will result in character death by sudden and unexplained organ failure. Elamon Cloudbreaker. Sex male, class wizard, level 14. Bio. Elamon, wizard of the third circle, an honorable advisor to King Tiberius, has felt the call of magic since childhood. Born to peasant folk in the village of Autumn Graves, Elamon hid his abilities for many years, in fear of being outcast by the village eldership. As a young man, Elamon grew in boldness, finally leaving Autumn Graves to seek instruction at the legendary Hall of Circles. Now he travels the world in search of knowledge, good company, and a smattering of gold. Abilities, communication, move object, astral projection, and ghostly push. Campaign ideas. Beneath the froth and foam, the villagers of Crendel's Keep know two things better than anyone else on the Widowed Sea. How to catch a stubborn herring with hook and line, and the taste of stubborn herring over fire. Life was simple there, and a little slow and hardly dangerous. Until the children started to disappear, it started with the brewmaster's son, then the smith's daughter, then the hunter's nephew, the more after. Calls went out to the monster hunter guilds, but not too many folk make it all the way down to Crendel's Keep. A good-hearted Crendelman, one Captain Dennis Salt, sailed to the port of Rye himself and put forth a plea to the guildmaster. It was then at last The call was heard, but would it be enough? The eternal prisoner, no one can say who built the call, the cell, in Ashtooth Forest, or how long it stood, or what manner of spell magic the stones. Yeah, magic the stones. Only that one man lives in the cell alone and blah blah blah, all been crossed out. And another campaign of the perfect city. No city in Karay compared to the bustling streets and dazzling spires of New Eden. It was not just the wealth, the artistry, or the safety found inside New Eden's walls. No, it was the total absence of everyday evil. Disease? Hunger? Theft? The citizens of New Eden raised perfect families and lived perfect lives. Neighboring kingdoms were desperate to forge alliances, but New Eden stood alone in all its great perfection. But perfection comes at a cost. Rubies and fire. The locals call it Daughter Flame, but the mountain had older names. Furnace Peak, Crimson Rock, and, if you ask the right wrinkled bookkeeper, Castus Elder Throne. It stretched past the clouds and filled the sky with an endless veil of soot. It also brought many travelers to its base, seeking the legendary treasure within. The Goat King Ozzy's built the vault in forgotten days and left his two undying sons to guard it. No one could remove a single coin, jewel, or crown from the... something.
So.
Okay.
Need a new Elamon campaign. My old notebook had some ideas in it that might work.
Well, I did just read through them. So, Rubies and Fire, Beneath the Froth and Foam, or the Perfect City. Okay, oh, wait, Rubies and Fire was a different thing. I thought it was all connected. I think the Perfect City is kind of interesting. Kind of reminds me of some, like, future... Well, the way I see it, I think it was, like, some futuristic, like, Cyberpunk 2077-esque kind of city. Although, I guess, you know, I know that game wasn't, like, the perfect city and, you know, didn't have, you know, no hunger and no disease and stuff, but that type of super futuristic-y city, you know? So I'm going with that. Brings us more into future times rather than medieval, you know? Oh, we got the 20-sided dice. I hope we can get a charisma 20 roll and a power 20 roll. You ready?
It would be really fun to reconnect with Mikey. It's been ages. But am I ready to GM a whole campaign again?
With your boy PG in the background. Hell yeah you are! We got this! You're gonna do great, trust me.
I gifted this to Mikey before I left for Seattle. Wonder if I'd even understand half of it now.
I'm sure you will. I'm sure she's gonna be like riding a bike. You give yourself 5-10 minutes, you'll pick it up, and you'll be good. It's like me with YouTube, you know, I took a little bit of a break from doing Let's Play style content. I did a lot of like scripted videos. Give me a couple videos back in, let me, you know, get back on, get a little bit of practice underneath. And you'll pick the skills back up, I'm sure. I'm confident in you, Steph. Alrighty then, bulletin board, what else we got?
Treat yourself this Valentine's Day. Call Fred's snow removal. What the hell?
Okay, you do you. Let's update.
If we don't have new releases, what do we have?
Let's take a look. 90s, 1790s. Ugh. I'm picking 1990s, if anything. Boy bands and girl groups and rock and roll. Okay.
It's throwback time.
Thank you for making that text a little less blurry. But anyway, that is what they call, what is it? Camera artistry? Photography skills? But doesn't help when I'm trying to read it. Okay, then. What are we doing with this thing?
Years of high school set design were preparing me for this moment. Oh, it just needs some screws.
Easy fix. We got this.
Is there an animal in there?
Is this gonna wait? Is it? Please be Valkyrie.
Hey, you in there. I'm coming back tomorrow with Febreze and a broom. So consider yourself warned.
Please be Valkyrie. No, because she said in the regular game, Valkyrie was in the walls or something, wasn't she? Oh, sorry, Valkyrie, you're gonna have to wait. We got a phone call. We'll be back, kitty cat, adorable girl, probably over there in the wall. Why are you in the wall as well? Anyway. All right. What's going on?
KRCT, Steph here.
Hey, are you the psychic?
Really?
Yeah, that's her.
You predicted I was going to dump Danny before I did it, right? So you're psychic.
Sure. Stay with that.
You know what? For the sake of filling some airtime, sure. I'm a psychic.
Why not?
I foretell shit.
That's so cool. Okay, so my best friend for basically my whole life, Tara, and I both got into CU. But then I got into UC, which is my dream school. I know I'm always supposed to follow my dreams, but I'm so scared of what will happen if I go to school without Tara. She's my rock.
Are you sure you want to talk about this with me?
Didn't we just go over this? Are you going to help me or not?
All right, we'll help.
Okay. Just give me a second. Damn. How do I tell this girl's future?
You're the psychic, apparently. We haven't met Allie. Oh. Fair enough.
All right. What am I going to tell this girl?
What are the chances?
A six is not great news.
Yeah, no.
What's my prediction?
You know, let's not say mortal enemy. Let's just say college dropout.
Okay.
You find plenty of careers without going to college. Right. Many you can when you do go to school, I guess, but you know.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
The good news is that you and Tara will definitely remain best friends. The bad news is that it's her fault you end up dropping out of college.
Really?
Yeah.
How?
Cult deprogramming? What?
Without her best friend nearby, Tara's judgment begins to falter. She joins in with a friendly group of agro-utopian poppy farmers, who are totally a cult.
Sure!
Yep. So you, clearly vying for best friend of the century, quit school and moved to Bumble County, Wyoming to infiltrate the group and set her free. In the end, you regain one safe and grateful best friend. But no diploma.
I guess that's the cost of best friendship.
All right. That's all I got. Hope it wasn't too brutal.
It was rough. But I think it'll help prepare me for the bumpy roads ahead. Thanks, Steph.
Anger life. When I pressed turn it off, I thought that was going to turn off, like, the microphone, not the lamp thing, but... Anyway!
I'm going to be shaking up the playlist a bit here at KRCT. So get your ears ready for some fresh tunes. And keep it here.
Oh, indeed. Sounds like a plan. Let's have a little listen. Chill out for a little bit. And just relax with some good old country. I don't know how you dance country in a face cam here, but you know what? This is the best we got. A little less energetic than normal, but it works. But I must say, as much as nice as it is, it is time to switch up the playlist. Can we get something else on, please? Country's alright, but I would have other preferences, if I'm being honest. What do we got? How about... Sure, the album cover looks cool. Let's go with it. See, and I know apparently there's meant to be a few... Like, songs in this DLC from artists that were in previous Life is Strange games. So, I believe Alt-J was from Life is Strange 1. They had a song in Falls. I believe did the ending song for the actual... Actually, I think it was for the ending we chose in Life is Strange 1. That was the song that played there, I believe. And yeah. All right, what do we got? Yeah, okay, cool. No one else. Great to know. Oh, Kylie.
Hunters. Barking up the wrong tree, I'm afraid.
Hey, cutie. We're excited to get to know you. Sorry, who's we? Me and Brayden. One assumes Brayden is like your pet iguana? No, Brayden is my boyfriend. We're looking for a third. Did you read our profile? No, I didn't. My bad. Yeah.
Nice.
Sorry.
Batting 1,000.
Whatever. Looks like you've been ghosted. You can no longer send messages to this user. Well, I probably should have read that better. Oh, well, we'll remember that for next time. Can we... Okay, yes. So, thoughts? Hell yeah, let's play. I'm down for some Dungeons and Dragons, baby. Dude, it's been way too long. I'm straight up hype about murdering Elamon again. Lol. Classic Steph Gingrich. Ging... Is it Gingrich or Ging... No, I don't want to say Gingrich. It's Gingrich. I don't know why I add an extra N in there, but anyway. Gabe, my dude, how you going? Yo, you're doing great. Give me a call towards the end of your shift for the debrief.
I'll just finish up whatever will do, I want my guy. To do, and then call Gabe.
Okay. Are there any other bits and pieces we can do? Yeah, let's just leave first. I'm gonna just do one last check through the store. Make sure there's no other changes, but we did the... what do you call it? We checked the vent, we did the posters, and I think we upgraded everything?
Eventually, I'll need to get back in the booth.
Oh, indeed we shall, but is there anything else we need to do? Okay, no, it is literally just call Gabe now. Okay, that is cool. Can we listen to anything whilst we're here?
When's the last time someone even used this?
I don't know, but we'll use it when we come visit. Got bait and tackle. Oh, the Lathe flowers. I'm gonna go say hello to Eleanor and Riley and the silver dragon. Go say hello to Charlotte over in her weed store. Yet again, I believe that's what a dispensary is. I still haven't properly looked that up from the regular game, but anyway. Alrighty then. Oh, Reed.
I've had maybe 3 conversations with Eleanor, and she's already giving me flowers. I can see why Gabe loves her.
Speaking of the wonderful Mrs. Eleanor, Steph, best of luck in this new adventure. We're also glad you decided to stick around. I'll bring it in the hugs again from Eleanor. You are so kind indeed.
Gabe, your girlfriend is too good for you, man.
Steph, have fun at the new gig. Don't worry. These chocolates are safe for work. Best, Char. Yes, thank you, Charlotte. And yes, I'm glad these are safe for work because I would not want to pull a Ren from Oxenfree and be, let's just say, have a little bit too much magic whilst we're live on air. If yous know what I mean. If yous have seen that series on Oxenfree, yous know what I mean. All right, let's go give my guy Gabe a call. Because I think it's time. I ain't gonna lie, this song is kind of cool. But it is phone call time. All right, Gabe.
Oh my God, am I caller number 12?
I'm so glad Gabe's back. He's such a cool character. I cannot hear you, Steph. Turn up the microphone. The music's too loud.
You know you're on the air, right?
Ow. Yep, we got a few skills to touch up and improve. Just mute our microphone. Using it for the ad read, very smart indeed. Now, can we please mute the microphone?
Rough first day, huh?
Yeah. Put it lightly there, but we're getting through. It's all cool, it's gonna be good, it's gonna be fine, it's gonna be dandy.